hear passage after passage, we have to read about bread. You know, we have a common already, if you will. You wonder, why do we keep mentioning bread in every prayer? Why do we keep speaking about bread all the time? I don't choose the scripture that we read every week. Almost every congregation in the LCA is reading these same passages this week, and we read along with Roman Catholics and most Protestants who are in the denominations. Well, the list repeats every few years, so every once in a while we come across the season of bread. When we talk about bread, reflect on bread, think about bread. Well, it gives us a chance during this time to reflect on our spiritual history, like Israel in the wilderness encountering manna for the first time. We're going to hear about the ravens feeding Elijah, and Elijah and Elijah feeding large crowds. It turns out there are lots of moments in scripture where bread plays a big role. Well, in today's gospel, most people who are following Jesus, they do not care about reflecting on their spiritual heritage. They don't want to think about the rich symbolism of bread. They just want to eat. Jesus fed 5,000 of them the day before with just a few loaves and fishes. The crowds who came and ate just as much as they wanted and were completely filled, they come back looking for Jesus, and they would like more, please. There are a lot of poor, food insecure people in Jesus' time. And though he fed 5,000 yesterday, today, of course, they need to eat again. They bring a physical hunger to Jesus. And he knows what's behind that. He knows they suffer from injustice, oppression by the authorities, callous disregard for pretty much everybody around them. Jesus understands how much of life is driven by the never-ending quest to fulfill our physical needs. Just like Jesus, we can look around us and see the consequences, the really dire consequences in our time and place for those who are not able to fulfill their own needs. Rows of tents under bridges and along freeway exit ramps, those remind us that hunger and need, injustice, oppression, callous disregard, they are just as much with us today as they were for these people who are following Jesus. For most people, getting what you need means long hours of work, physical exhaustion, anxiety, our bills, debts. Everything we need to do to satisfy our very real physical needs. Those are just part of everyday life, promise everything. Well, Jesus understands the hunger of those who have come looking for him. But instead of producing another meal for them out of bits and pieces, as he did the day before, Jesus challenges them to think more about their profound hunger. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, Jesus says. And you think that maybe a hungry crowd might resent that kind of answer. But no, they respond to Jesus because they realize, like most of us, that yes, much of life is driven by our physical needs, but we hunger for other things as well. And some of those things are really good things to ponder. For instance, lots of people today, they choose to be sick. They have made a choice that's going to affect so many areas of their lives, and it makes sense that you would spend a lot of time thinking about that. What's this going to mean for me in terms of having a family, living with a family, living alone, having enough money, having enough security? All kinds of questions. It's a big decision whether or not you commit to somebody else in a relationship. And so it makes sense that you would spend is happy being single. And thinking about all of these questions sometimes can get to be a little obsessive. No one's going to die from being single, as they would from not having food. But it represents a need, a whole set, a whole constellation of needs that demand something from us, demand our attention, demand decisions. You could say that people who are making all of these decisions and reflecting all the time on this, they are experiencing a hunger and not sure exactly what satisfying that is going to look like. Well, if you turn that good kind of reflection around and you think about hunger in a different way, you might think about addictions as a hunger disorder. Everybody has deep-seated needs, desires. We hunger after things. And an addiction can fill those empty places, at least for a short time. But addictive substances or activities, they can't fill you for very long. They just make you feel that they mask the deeper problem, this deeper need, this deeper hunger that you have. You might identify it as emptiness, a restlessness. But when Jesus sees the crowds, he knows that they not only have a physical hunger, but he understands that everybody has this kind of deep-seated hunger. Well, during this season of bread, it's a good time to think about Jesus' really unspoken question to the crowds. What is it that you hunger for? Can you name it? Can you think about your life chasing after it sometimes? It's a time to reflect on Jesus' advice to those who begin to follow him from this crowd. Don't be consumed by chasing after your next dream. Don't be consumed